Good morning, students. Let us continue with Geography Chapter 4, Climate. In our previous video, we had learnt about the advancing monsoon. Isn't it, students? Today, in this video, we are going to learn about the retreating or post-monsoons, which is also called as the transition season. Okay, let's begin. During October-November, with the apparent movement of the sun towards the south, the monsoon trough or the low pressure trough over the northern plains becomes weaker. Now let us try to understand this with the help of the map. Students, here you can see the monsoon trough in the northern plain, isn't it, students? Now you are aware about the term monsoon trough, isn't it? We had already learnt about this in our previous video. Let us revise once again. What is monsoon trough? Yes, monsoon trough is the name given to the region in the ITCZ which has low pressure. Now, what do you mean by ITCZ? Yes, it's intertropical convergence zone. Okay, students. Now, during October-November, with the apparent movement of the sun towards the south, the monsoon trough or the low pressure trough over the northern plains becomes weaker. Okay, students, just have a look at this map, students. Here you can see, due to the apparent movement of the sun towards the south, what happens? The monsoon trough or the low pressure trough over the northern plains becomes weaker. Okay, hope it is clear. This is gradually replaced by a high pressure system. So this is gradually replaced by the high pressure. Earlier it was low pressure, isn't it, students? Now it is replaced by high pressure. The southwest monsoon winds weaken and start withdrawing gradually. Okay, students. So as a result, the southwest monsoon winds get weakened and they, what do? Yes, they start withdrawing gradually from our country. Okay, students, and you are aware that winds blow from high pressure to low pressure, isn't it? So during this time, that is October-November period, okay, the winds start blowing from high pressure region, that is land, towards the sea, which is the low pressure region. Okay, students, the monsoon withdraws from the northern plains by the beginning of October. So when do the monsoon withdraw from the northern plains? Yes, the monsoon withdraws from the northern plains from the beginning of October. Okay. The months of October, November form a period of transition. Now, what do you mean by transition? Yes, transition means change. Okay. So the months of October, November form a period of transition from hot rainy season to dry winter conditions. Okay. Now let us talk about the features of retreating monsoon. Okay, during this season, we can see clear skies and there is rise in the temperature. Okay, students, the day temperatures are high, but nights are cool and pleasant. Okay, students, though the day temperatures are high, but nights are cool and pleasant. Due to the high temperature and humidity, the weather becomes oppressive. Okay, the weather becomes harsh during the daytime. So this phenomenon is known as October heat. Now what do you mean by October heat? Let us try to understand. Due to the high temperature and humidity, the weather becomes oppressive during the daytime. And this phenomenon is known as October heat. So due to the high temperature and humidity, the weather becomes oppressive during the daytime and it is called as October heat. Okay, students. In the second half of October, let's see what happens. The temperature begins to fall rapidly in the northern India. Okay, students. So in the first half of the October, we find high temperature, but in the second half of October, the temperature begins to fall rapidly in the northern India. Okay. Now let us learn about the cyclonic depression and tropical cyclone. Okay. The low pressure conditions over northwestern India get shifted to the Bay of Bengal by early November. Okay, just have a look at this map, students. Here you can see the low pressure conditions over northwestern India. Okay, that is ITCZ. You can see in the map, isn't it, students? It gets shifted to the Bay of Bengal by early November. Can you see, students? There is a shift of ITCZ from northwestern India towards the Bay of Bengal. Okay, so because of this, what happens? Low pressure area is formed in Bay of Bengal, isn't it? And this shift is associated with the occurrence of cyclonic depressions. And where does it originate? Yes, it originates over the Andaman Sea. Okay, students. And the cyclones generally cross the eastern coast of India, causing heavy and widespread rain. So due to these cyclones, what happens? There is heavy rainfall towards the eastern coast of India. Okay, and these tropical cyclones are often very destructive. Okay, students, there is loss of life, okay, and the property is damaged and so on. Sometimes these cyclones arrive at the coast of Odisha, West Bengal and Bangladesh. Students, in this map you can see these cyclones sometimes arrive at the coast of Odisha, West Bengal and Bangladesh. Okay, these cyclones frequently strike the populated deltas, the Godavari, the Krishna and the Kaveri. So these cyclones frequently strike the populated deltas of the river Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. Okay. The bulk of the rainfall of the Coromandel coast is derived from depressions and cyclones. So here in this map you can see the Coromandel coast. Okay, students, the bulk of the rainfall, that is much of the rainfall of the Coromandel coast, is derived from the depression and the cyclones. Okay, students, now let us talk about the monsoon. Okay, as a unifying bond, how does it unite? The Himalayas protect the subcontinent from extremely cold winds from Central Asia. Now students, you all are aware about this fact, isn't it? The Himalayas protect the subcontinent from the cold winds blowing from the Central Asia, isn't it? So this enables northern India to have uniformly higher temperatures compared to other areas on the same latitudes. So because of this, what happens? Yes, it enables the northern India to have uniformly higher temperatures compared to that of other areas on the same latitudes. Why does it happen? Yes, because of the Himalayas. As Himalayas protect the subcontinent from extremely cold winds from the Central Asia, okay, the North India has uniformly higher temperatures compared to that of the other areas on the same latitudes. Okay. The peninsular plateau has moderate temperatures due to the influence of the sea from three sides. Now why is it so, students? Yes, because the peninsular plateau is surrounded by water from three sides. Because of this, peninsular plateau has moderate temperature. Okay. Despite such moderate influences, there are great variations in the temperature conditions. Okay. Despite such moderating influences, there are great changes or there are great variations in the temperature conditions. Okay. The seasonal alternation of wind systems and the associated weather conditions provide a rhythmic cycle of seasons. Now, how does the rhythmic cycle of seasons take place? Yes, it is because of the seasonal alternation of wind systems and the associated weather conditions. Okay. Even the uncertainties of rain and uneven distribution are very much typical of the monsoons. Now, what do you mean by the uncertainties of rain? Yes, the rain is uncertain. Okay. And uneven distribution? Yes, somewhere the regions receive
high rainfall, some regions receive scanty rainfall, isn't it? So the uncertainties of rain and uneven distribution are very much typical of the monsoons. Okay. The Indian landscape, its animals and plant life, agricultural activities, and the life of the people, all are dependent on the effects of the monsoon. So the Indian landscape, its animals and plant life, even the agricultural activities, okay, these all are dependent upon the monsoon. Okay, students. The monsoon provides the water to set agricultural activities in motion. Isn't it, students? You all are aware. For agricultural activity, we require water. And this we obtain from the monsoon. So the monsoon provides the water to set the agricultural activities in motion. And hence, the arrival of the monsoon is awaited eagerly. Why do people wait eagerly for the arrival of the monsoon? Yes, because the monsoon provides the water to set the agricultural activities in motion. Okay, students, hope this is clear. The river valleys which carry this water also unite as a single river valley unit. So, students, the river valleys which replenish its water level, okay, it unites as a single river unit to provide water for human consumption as well as for the agricultural needs. Okay, so students, I hope you have understood monsoon as a unifying bond. Okay, now it's time for quiz. I hope you all are ready for the quiz. Okay, let's begin. Question number one. Which prevents the southwest monsoon winds from escaping from India? Option A, the Indian deserts. Option B, the Himalayas. Option C, low pressure over Central Asia. Option D, none of these. Yes, students, which is the correct answer? Yes, you are right. The correct answer is option B, the Himalayas. The Himalayas prevents the southwest monsoon winds from escaping from India. Very good.
Next question. In which month the transition season changes the hot rainy season to dry winter season? Option A, October, November. Option B, December, January. Option C, February, March. Option D, June, July. Yes, students, which is the correct answer? Yes, you are right. The correct answer is option A, October, November. Okay. Next question. The retreat of the monsoon is marked by clear skies and rising temperature. Option A, true. Option B, false. Yes, which is the correct answer? Yes, the correct answer is option A, true. The retreat of the monsoon is marked by clear skies and rising temperature is the correct statement. Okay. Next question. The seasonal alternation of the wind systems and the associated weather conditions provide a rhythmic cycle of seasons. Option A, false. Option B, true. Yes, which is the correct answer? Yes, the correct answer is option B, true. The seasonal alternation of the wind systems and the associated weather conditions provide a rhythmic cycle of seasons is a correct statement. Okay. Now, here is the question based on assertion and reason. Okay. Assertion. During retreating monsoon, October heat is common phenomenon. Reason. During retreating monsoon, due to high temperature and humidity, the weather becomes oppressive during the daytime. Option A. Both A and R are true and R is the correct explanation of A. Option B. Both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. Option C. A is true, but R is false. Option D. A is false, but R is true. Once again, let us read the question. Assertion. During retreating monsoon, October heat is common phenomenon. reason. During retreating monsoon, due to high temperature and humidity, the weather becomes oppressive during the daytime. Yes, which is the correct answer, students? Yes, you are right. The correct answer is option A. Both assertion and reason are true, and the reason given is the correct explanation of assertion. Okay. So students, let us have a quick recap. Today in this video, we had learnt about the retreating monsoons as well as monsoon as a unifying bond. Okay, hope you have understood the topics covered today. With this, we have come towards the end of the lesson. We have completed this chapter. Okay, so you are supposed to read the textbook thoroughly, students. Okay, and meet you in the next video. Till then, bye and take care.